What we're gonna do now is this area's been cleared of weeds, and we're gonna put down some topsoil I have here because the dirt's not deep enough. You're asking maybe why is the dirt not deep enough to plant in? I got some purple potatoes. I went to the garden center to buy these and they were sold out. They go really quick here and I waited too late in the season. These don't look that great, but we're gonna try them because this is all they have left. And I'd like to thank the manager at Vineyard Garden Center in Orem, Utah. She gave these to me free out of her own personal collection from home because they had none left in the store. So we're gonna go over here and plant them right now in about 6 to 10 inches of soil. Okay, so now as you can see, this soil is just as rich as the other. And I'm just gonna break this up a little bit. Just go through here and break up the soil somewhat. I'm gonna leave the berry plants alone and the grapevines. We don't need that rock in here. And then we're gonna plant these purple potatoes, which this one's pretty good. So we're gonna plant these, and then we have all this room to come up with the soil. And these like 6 to 10 inches of soil, loose soil. So I'm gonna put the bags of soil over each of these with some compost. So I'm gonna get to digging this up right now. Okay, now what we've done here is I've dug these holes down about 4 inches, some of them maybe not quite. But look how rich and dark this soil is. So once we have all these holes, we're gonna take some compost and put it in each of the holes. All right, so I'm taking a scoop of the organic, weed-free turkey compost that I've had really good luck with, and I put it in each of these holes. Now that every hole has one, we're gonna grab some potatoes and just drop them in. It's easy as that. I grew these like this a few years ago, had really good luck. So just dropping one potato in each of the holes. Sorry about the camera shake, I'm hand holding it and I had to switch hands. There we go. And I miscounted. I apparently don't know how to count. So I have two extra holes. All right, let's go ahead and cover them up with some dirt now. And now we're gonna take a bag of dirt. We have just plain topsoil here. And I've done this before too, and it works really good. Cut this bag open and just cover everything up. And this is just number one. We're gonna put more topsoil in. This is just for today to get it covered. We're gonna try and raise this up at least 6 inches. It's about 4 inches in the ground, so that'll give us 10 inches that, up to 10 inches that potatoes like. Loose, fresh topsoil dirt. This works really quick. Just get yourself a simple box cutter, really cheap box cutter, and just zip it right along the bottom of the bag. It goes right in. All the dirt goes in. It's quick and easy to do it this way. Instant garden. Raise it right up. And I missed a spot right here, so we're gonna come back and get this one. I want to make sure they're all covered good. Now they're all covered. I have a few extra bags, so we're gonna put these in too. And this earth soil here is cheap. I don't know how much it costs in your area, it was only $2 here. $2 a bag. It's a quick fix. to raising a garden bed. You don't have to buy it all at once. So get what you can when you can. And then let's level this out. We'll put the rest of the turkey compost on it. One benefit of having all these bags is they make great cat toys. Kitties love to play hide and seek in the bags. Zeus is here somewhere. Do you see Zeus anywhere? Do you see a kitty hiding under a bag? Is there a kitty right there? Zeus! Zeus has claimed this bag to live underneath it now. Funny kitty cat. 15-pound tabby completely hidden underneath this bag. Oh, there's his rear hanging out. Zeus, what are you doing? He's like, go away, I'm hiding. Now we're going to level this out. I have a simple landscaping rake. We're just gonna spread this around. And this isn't all the soil I'm gonna do. This is just to get the potatoes in the ground because they're way past due. We'll add more soil later. Oh, I better not step on that bag. That's the one Zeus is under. Okay. This is good. This looks pretty deep for these potatoes here. So the potatoes have a nice, warm, cozy bed. And I have a little bit of compost left. Not much. So I'm going to spread some of this compost around on top. It helps retain the moisture and it feeds them even better. Feed the potatoes some more. But we don't want plastic in here. So that's the end of that compost. We'll just kind of spread it around a little bit, leave it on top. And we'll get all this wet and it will soak in. Make a turkey compost. That's it. The potatoes are planted, let's water them. Now the last thing we need to do is water. We just planted the potatoes, covered them with fresh soil and turkey compost. We need to soak them. So we just want to cover them really good with water. You almost want to leave the hose in here running. To water these really good, really long. Potatoes love lots of water. Okay, that's it for another webisode of Small Plot Basic Gardening. The potatoes are all planted, and be sure to like us on YouTube. Leave comments, we love comments. Next week, we're going back to the center planter. We're gonna do broccoli. Be sure to check in next week. Thanks for watching. Have a great week. And through the magic of delayed video broadcast, I bring you potato sprouts. So these are two of them, probably one potato with two sprouts coming off of it. And I don't see any others yet. These are the first two to come up. That's what they look like. Little tiny potato sprouts. Purr, Zeusy, purr.